Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Cox Field, located on the campus of UNCP. Today we got a Peach Belt Conference action with Montevallo Falcons, and your Braves of UNCP. I'm Scott Banky.
And I'm Morgan Sheehan.
And today we got ourselves a very, very interesting matchup, kind of going into game two of this series. Game one was a very interesting series, ended up walk-off hit by the Braves to left field. I mean, 6-5, Montevallo put up a really good fight.
It was a very exciting game. If you were not here for that game yesterday, you missed out on very good baseball game. Lots of hitting. Really not that many errors. I believe there's only one error, and that was by Montevallo, but hopefully we have another good game today.
Yes, indeed. Coming into the game, the Montevallo Falcons are 5-4. A lot of their games have been really close, all decided by one run. They started the season 0-3, ended up going into a 5-game winning streak entering the series, but ended up going back to a 1-game losing streak against the Braves.
And really, Montevallo and UNC Pembroke, they have a history of going into extra innings. Last year, when the Braves played at Montevallo, first game went into 11 innings. Braves came out on top. Second game was also 11 innings, and the Braves lost that one, and they ended up losing the series in the third game, which was played in 9 innings. So, you know, extra innings seem to be the word for these two teams.
Yes. So if you are watching, just make sure you grab some popcorn, because you might be able to get some, you know, a little bit of extra inning action as we start off with the visiting team Montevallo Falcons, starting off at center fielder Daniel Pardo, shortstop the junior Dane Hutchin, the designated hitter Jeremy Hyde, the first baseman Taylor Walker, the second baseman Matthew Ferruto, left fielder Chad Wagner, right fielder Colin Dupree, the catcher Jacob Whiting, and at third baseman batting ninth Chase Bryan. Pitcher Aaron McGree, 1-0, has pitched 9 innings in the season, has 10 strikeouts, doing an excellent job for, you know, Montevallo Falcons. We could have a really tough matchup here for the Braves this evening.
Very low ERA as well, so this could be this could end up being really a pitcher's duel if you want to look down to it, because for the Braves, Lane Johnson is on the mound with an ERA of 1.80. He started one game with 5 innings pitched, so, you know, I think we're in for a really good matchup today.
Indeed. As we announce the starting lineup for your Braves of UNCP, the right fielder, Nick Debo, did an excellent job. He's, 3-for-4 on stolen bases this season, .310 average, doing an excellent job. We got Drew Beaver at second base, designated hitter Justin Datillo, third baseman Hayden Bufkin. Batter number 5, Stabell Almansaba, has had an excellent season, .600 batting average. You don't see that much.
Definitely somebody to watch.
Yeah. First baseman Daniel Oxendine, center fielder Nolan Pierce, catcher Alex Mitten, and shortstop Robert Rivera. Pitching for the Braves today, Lane Johnson, number 44. Hasn't gotten a win yet, but has pitched 5 innings, 1.8 ERA. He's definitely, you know, he's given up a lot of hits, but not a lot of runs at all, which is doing an excellent job for the Braves.
It really shows that, you know, the Braves have a strong defense. They lost a lot of key players last year. They had a lot of holes they had to fill, but to start off the season, it really looks like they haven't lost anybody. They have a lot of young guys that have come in, and even Coach Paul O'Neill, he said that yesterday in his post-game interview, that a lot of young guys are being thrown into action, and they're really stepping up to the plate.
Yes, as we mentioned, the Braves are 8-0 right now, 1-0 conference, that first conference win coming against Montevallo. They're number 6 in the nation right now, looking for 9-0 to keep that perfect season alive for them. When you have a player like Stabell Almansaba, .600, that's really tough to argue, especially what the Braves have gone through in the past year, losing a very, one of their top caliber players on the team, probably within the past 4 years, I would say.
Collins Cutherell, third baseman for the Braves, he graduated last year, had 91 hits, 75 runs, 22 doubles, and 25 home runs. When you lose the Peach Belt Conference Player of the Year, 3-time PBC Player of the Week, and an All-American, that's pretty tough. And Hayden Bufkin had very big shoes to fill, and he's definitely stepped up to the plate. Collins Cutherell led the Peach Belt in 10 different statistical categories. You do not hear of that very often.
That is, I mean, you don't even hear, like, I don't even hear that in, like, Division I schools or big, like, powerhouse colleges in the NCAA. And to hear someone that has leading statistics in 10 different stats, I mean, that is really, really difficult.
All right, and we have number 4, Daniel Pardo, stepping up to the plate for the Falcons. Pardo is coming in with a .289 average, 38 at-bats, 10 runs scored, 11 hits, 2 doubles, and 1 home run, and 5 RBIs.
Yes, as it looks like Lane Johnson, breaking ball pitch to the left side, ball one, or excuse me, strike one, count ahead in his favor, 0-1. Pardo, 2 for 5 yesterday with 2 RBIs, as 0-1 pitch, fouled left, count now 0-2 in the pitcher's, in Braves' favor, Lane Johnson.
This is good to see Lane Johnson already starting ahead early, and hopefully he can just start early and stay ahead in the count.
Yes, this is a very crucial point, especially with the first batter of the game. You know, could be definitely be that momentum swing for the Braves as the 0-2 delivery underway. Way outside in the batter's box, ball 1-2, count 1-2.
I feel like for Johnson to be successful today in his outing, he really needs to start ahead in his count and stay ahead. That give him a little bit of cushion and a little bit of, you know, relaxation on the mound.
1-2 delivery fouled back again, staying alive. Daniel Pardo is count still 1-2. Done an excellent job. When we speak of the Montevallo Falcons, the one thing I did not mention was the 5-game winning streak that they were on. Every game they had double-digit runs. I mean, that is a very... You know, that's a very tough to pull off in a 5-game span. And, you know, that could be definitely a huge threat for Lane Johnson as the 1-2 delivery goes underway. Hits the pitcher, or hits, Daniel Pardo as he jogs over to first. Looks okay.
Looks like it hit him, you know, in the higher back, maybe on his shoulder area. At least it's not too cold today, so, you know, it wouldn't sting like it would last weekend.
Yes, up next we have Dane Hutchin, who went 1-for-5 in the previous game yesterday, if you did miss it.
And speaking of yesterday's win for the Braves, it actually broke a 5-game win streak that Montevallo had for the Braves. So very big and exciting win for the Braves yesterday.
That's the first pitch. Is a dagger to the left field. Looks like caught by... Stabel Almansaba making, you know, great defensive play. We earlier in the pregame, we did talk about his offensive stats, 600 batting average. We know definitely, you know, showing his defensive side as well.
Now up to bat for the Falcons, number 28 designated hitter Jeremy Hyde. Hyde for the season is batting .353. 34 at-bats, 11 runs, 12 hits, 2 doubles, 3 home runs, and 13 RBIs. In the starting lineup for the Falcons today, he ranks second in RBIs.
That's the first pitch for Larry Johnson. Is strike one, 0-1 count, one out, run on first. Daniel Pardo being on first after getting hit by a pitch.
Hyde yesterday had 2 hits, 1 run scored, and 1 RBI. So not too bad of a day for Jeremy Hyde. Lane Johnson throws back to first, trying to pick off the runner. Not too big of a lead on first right now for Daniel Pardo. Lane Johnson looks back to make sure that he's staying honest and true to first base and doesn't get too big of a lead. Count for Jeremy Hyde right now. 1 strike, no balls, 1 out.
Larry Johnson again checking at that first pace. 0-1 delivery about to be underway. Runner takes off. Ooh, very close play. And he gets him out. What a throw by the catcher, Alex Mitten. I mean,
that throw was right on target. Could not have asked for a better throw.
Jeremy Hyde looked like he was in the way. Did not even move at all. You know, and of course, you got to give credit to the umpire for still making the call in that bang-bang play situation.
I mean, that throw, like I said, you really cannot ask for a more perfect throw.
As the count moves to 0-2, two outs now instead of one. Larry Johnson looking to end, go easy as 1-2-3. 0-2 delivery. Way outside. Count moved to 1-2. One, two delivery. A little left and low, ball two. As the count now moves to 2-2. Larry Johnsino had the really good job of getting ahead in the count, but just can't seem to find the strike zone after that stolen base. 2-2 delivery. Fouled back, still the count 2-2. Jeremy Hyde staying alive.
This is in the first three batters, you know, besides the first one getting hit by the pitch. This is, I mean, this right now is a good test for Lane Johnson, right-handed pitcher for the Braves. See, can he work in adverse situations? Low ball in the left-hander's batter's box. Full count now for Jeremy Hyde.
Lane Johnson taking his time, ready to deliver the full count. Delivery 3-2. Little low, ball four, as looks like Jeremy Hyde's taking his first at bat as a walk.
Up next for the Falcons, first baseman, number 40, Taylor Walker.
Up next we have the first baseman, number 40, Taylor Walker, the junior, batting .556 coming into this game.
Very impressive batting average. Yesterday, Walker had five at-bats, two runs, two hits.
As the first pitch delivery for Taylor Walker is strike one, swing and miss. 0-1, two outs, runner on first. Jeremy Hyde just taking a little typical lead at first, you know.
Not getting too far ahead of himself, really.
Yeah, he does have the advantage since Lane Johnson is a right-handed pitcher. 0-1 delivery, way outside for count moving to 1-1 now. One and one count, Lane Johnson delivery.
Taylor Walker yesterday also had a double. So, you know, this is somebody that could possibly become a threat eventually for the Braves. Really somebody to keep an eye on. Like we said, very impressive batting average, not afraid to swing. And with runners in scoring position, he would be somebody I would be very concerned about.
Yes, Taylor Walker with the swing and a miss, 1-2 count. We're ready for the 1-2 delivery, waiting to put him away. Almost hitting his knees, count moving to 2-2. You know, like we said, like mentioned, Taylor Walker is definitely, you know, that guy, that go-to guy for the Falcons. You know, having he scored two runs in the previous game, even though did not have an RBI, but he's definitely, you know, that one guy that could put runners in the scoring position or get those runners in scoring position at home. Looks like Bufkin just chasing a foul ball, count moving to 2-2.
You know, and with these games, with Montevallo and UNC Pembroke having history of going into extra innings, really, when you get runners on the base pass, you need to capitalize on them. And, I mean, if you get runners on first and second and Taylor Walker, is coming up to bat, he could be one who could, you know, send the game in extra innings or win the game for someone.
Indeed, as the 2-2 delivery is a little outside to the right of the plate, count moving the full count, 3-2. Runner on first with two outs. Jeremy Hyde got hit by or walked on full count, full I believe. Count. As the 3-2 count, look, he looks like he's gonna take off, swing and a miss, fouled, tipped, still count at full. Looks like Jeremy Hyde is probably gonna do the same thing again. I mean, two outs, you know, really full count. I mean, whatever happens, whether swing and a miss or contact, he's still gonna take off.
This would be the second batter in a row that Lane Johnson has had to face 3-2 and have the batter foul off multiple pitches. So really, this is a good test for him in the first inning.
Yeah, Taylor Walker doing an excellent job staying alive with the 3-2 delivery, almost hitting him again as he walks over to first. That is the second walk of the inning.
Second consecutive walk. You know, that this could be a nerve, you know, a lot of nerves going on, but hopefully he can settle down and really focus in right now.
Yes, up next we have Matthew Furuto, the junior second baseman. Had five at-bats, no hits. Really don't have much statistics on him.
He's batting .353, 34 at-bats on the season so far, 10 runs, 12 hits, 3 doubles, 1 triple, and 1 home run, and 8 RBIs. So, consistent hitter. I wouldn't necessarily call him your power hitter, but somebody who could get on base and could really be beneficial on the base pass.
Yes, Matthew Furuto up to plate, fouled back the first pitch, count moving to 0-1. Runners on first and second. Lane Johnson kind of have one runner scoring position. Two outs can be very deadly for the Falcons. I mean, he's done well with runners on the base this inning. I mean, with the hit by pitch, he had that runner on and was able to get the stolen base. I mean, ever since that moment, he's really just haven't been in rhythm as the 0-1 delivery is now a strike. 0-2, Lane Johnson ahead in the count.
You know, a lot of pitchers, after they hit someone, especially to start off the game, that can really affect them throughout the game and the rest of the inning. And really, Lane Johnson hasn't had that affect him too much. You know, he had two consecutive walks, but I think throwing the runner out, Pardo out at second, you know, that really helped him and gave him some momentum.
Yes, a fly ball to left field, hitting the foul ball. Saba hustling over, unable to make the grab. Count remains still 0-2. As Furuto staying alive here in the at-bat, that could have been a very deadly situation if it was just slightly right of the white line. Furuto taking a little practice swing one more time before entering back in the box.
Lane Johnson ahead in the count, 0-2. Runners on second and first with two outs.
Lane Johnson has done an excellent job this season. Really just been ahead in the count, just able to, you know, he's as soon as the first couple of pitches are usually, you know, strikes or foul balls, but doing an excellent job, but hasn't been able to capitalize as the 0-2 delivery underway. Off the plate, count moving to 1-2.
Lane Johnson ready to deliver the 1-2 pitch. Low and count moves to 2-2.
Just like we mentioned earlier, just getting ahead in the count. I mean, you know, usually that would give, you know, that pit would give Lane Johnson like a huge confidence boost. You know,
starting 0-2, you know,
giving him a little bit more comfortable. But just I think he's just trying to get these batters to just basically chase the pitch, try to test them, see what they're swinging at, see if they're, you know, a little anxious as well.
Which is a big credit to Montevallo. They're very patient at the plate.
As strike three, Lane Johnson ends the inning with. With no hits, no runs.
Two runners left on base.
And zero errors. And we are back for some Peach Belt Conference action. Bottom of the first, Braves up to bat. In the first, let's talk about the recap the first half of the inning. You know, Lane Johnson did an excellent job getting ahead in the count, but was just unable to just honestly just finish the bat. He like hit a pitcher. He had two walks, and I believe
the last one's a strikeout looking.
Yeah, I mean, did an excellent job, you know, finishing the inning, but was just in the middle of the inning was just very sketch, just a little uncomfortable as right fielder Nick Deba leading off for the Braves steps up into the box. Nick Debo's first pitch is a strike, count moving to 0-1. Correction, Nick Debo.
Debo is batting .310 for the season, and he also had a home run in yesterday's game. He's somebody who can really spark the lineup. He's a transfer.
One out delivery for Montevallo. Off the plate, count moving to 2-0 in favor of the Braves. Braves do an excellent job with that plate. With the plate discipline, you know, probably one of the toughest aspects of batting is, you know, you're really anxious to go up there and swing it, but, you know, Braves do an excellent job not getting fooled by Montevallo pitching. As the 2-0 delivery, foul to left, count moving to 2-1.
Yesterday in the game, Nick Debo was at bat three times, one run, two hits, one RBI, one walk. He was left on base twice.
Like we mentioned earlier, Nick Debo is definitely, you know, one of the fastest runners on the team. You know, 3-for-4 in stealing as the 2-1 delivery is underway.
Nick Debo strikes out looking.
Like we mentioned, Nick Debo is definitely, you know, one of the faster players on the squad, you know, just unable to get on base. Up next, we have Drew Beaver.
Beaver's batting .241 right now in the season, 29 at bats, 8 runs, 7 hits, 2 doubles, 2 home runs, and 4 RBIs. He's been walked 5 times, which in the starting lineup for the Braves, him and Roberto Rivera, they both have 5 walks. This just shows that they're very patient at the plate. Very good plate discipline as well.
Yeah, Drew Beaver definitely, you know, trying to go for the quick bunt, but pulls back, strike one, count moving to 0-1, one out, no runners on base, as the 0-1 delivery is underway. Dagger to left field. Looks like it is foul.
Very close, though. 0-2 count for Drew Beaver.
Yeah, that could have been an easy double for the Braves, but just a little close to the more left side of the white line.
When looking at the starting lineup for the Braves, Drew Beaver is really the only returner besides people that are on our pitching staff that are one of our key returners, and he's the only one who's really experienced a lot of playing time for the Braves so far. So really he's I would consider him one of Pembroke's biggest like leaders on the field right now. He has more experience. Count now 1-2 for Drew Beaver.
Yes, you know, experience definitely, you know, takes a long, it definitely helps you a lot throughout the season as the 1-2 delivery is underway. Pop up, looks like Whiting going over, but out of play. Like we mentioned, you know, the experience that the Braves have, they have 6 juniors on today's line. I mean, that is a lot of, you know, people who have played, you know, in the, not necessarily play, but have been in the experience of college baseball and understand the situations at hand and able to, you know, keep the composure that most players really have a hard time managing.
Coming into this, like, big of a stage.
As a 1-2 delivery, another foul looks like towards Walker. Walker looking over to make the grab.
Looks like Walker caught it, too.
Yeah, excellent hustle by Walker as 2 outs now. Justin Dottillo, the designated hitter, up to bat.
Dottillo is batting .481 on the season, 27 at bats, 9 runs, 13 hits, 3 doubles, 1 home run, and 5 RBIs.
Justin Dottillo did not get a hit. However, he was left on base twice. So even though he was, you know, not necessarily, you know, being the most beneficial by getting a base hit, but was still able to get on base, just could not able to get scored as the first pitch for him is a strike. Count moving to 0-1. as the 0-1 delivery is underway. Little low, count moving to 1-1. Aaron McGree doing an excellent job on the mound so far. Looking for the 1-2-3 for the inning. 1-1 delivery. Grounded towards Ferruto. Easy routine play to Walker as that ends the inning.
No runners left on base. No hits for the Braves. No errors and no runs. We'll be right back.
Braves, no runs, no hits, no errors, no runners.
And we are back here at the top of the second inning now. Braves, to recap the bottom half of the first inning, could not get anything going. Dito struck out, Beaver flew out, and the Tillo did a routine grounder. As it looks like it is Chad Wagner up to bat here in this ball game. Takes first pitch as strike one. Chad Wagner played left field. 3-for-4, you know, one of the big players that helped out in the previous game, if you missed it yesterday, as the 0-1 delivery is underway. Little outside for ball one. It kept moving to 1-1. You know, Chad Wagner, you know, he's kind of being that little bit of a hothead in this game, you know, after what happened last series, as the 1-1 delivery is grounded towards Bufkin, throw to Walker. Oxendine, my apologies, for out number one.
Right fielder, number six, Colin Dupree.
Up next we have the right fielder, number six, Colin Dupree. The sophomore has only started one game this season for the Falcons, has played in seven, so it's definitely, you know, kind of getting his opportunity here against the Braves to start. You know, he's definitely someone who has worked their way up into, you know, the order. As his first pitch is a ball, count moving to 1-0. Colin Dupree actually played substitute for Jeremy High yesterday as that ball is a grounder, splitting the gap, third base and shortstop. As the first hit of the game is underway.
The catcher, number 8, Jacob Whiting.
Up next we have the catcher, Jacob Whiting, 1-for-2 in yesterday's game, scoring a run in that hit. Lane Johnson doing excellent jobs. One out, one run on first. First pitch for Whiting. Ball one.
Jacob Whiting on the season is batting 400, 28 at bats, 8 runs, 8 hits, No doubles or triples, but two home runs and six RBIs.
Yes, definitely not one of, you know, your speediest players, you know, on the team, but definitely someone who knows how to make contact and send that ball flying, as the 1-0 delivery is underway.
As it looks like Lane Johnson just checking over at first base. The 1-0 delivery, ball fouled left, count moving to 1-1. Lane Johnson getting settled on the mound. Jacob Whiting just looks like there's a little discretion with the Braves and home plate umpire, Ryan Combs.
Yesterday, Jacob Whiting had two at-bats, one run, one hit, no RBIs, and he was walked twice.
As Lane Johnson checks over at first place, looking at Dupree, you know, definitely know one guy that definitely has the hasn't had any attempts, but, you know, you don't want to, you know, test that theory, you know, just according to this, just by looking at stat sheets. Hasn't had a stolen base attempt or anything, but, you know, that could be his first attempt could be today.
Lane Johnson keeping the Falcon runners very honest on first.
As the 0-2 delivery is strike three. Three pitches, three strikes.
Really looks like coming into the second inning, Lane Johnson has really settled in, kind of found his groove, you know, maybe, like we mentioned, it was nerves to start the game off, but he looks a lot more calm and really in the zone.
Yes, as Chase Bryant, the third baseman at the end of the order for the Falcons, steps in, the senior. Really hasn't had the hot start, .091 batting average entering today's game, as Lane Johnson again keeps checking over at Dupree.
Chase Bryant yesterday came in to play third base later on in the game and replaced J.D. Minor.
As the first pitch for Bryant is a strike. Lane Johnson in favor, 0-1. Two outs, runner on first. The 0-1 delivery, runner takes off. Strike. Safe over at second base. Dupree with the steal, like we mentioned earlier. First steal of the season. First attempt, first steal for Dupree. You know. You know, now runner Dupree in scoring position for the Falcons. Could be a deadly threat. You know, 0-2, but Lane Johnson's a little composed at the mound. You know, he has a little room to work with. You know, can throw some chasing pitches with no balls, two strikes.
Just really doesn't want to get too far behind in the count or lose this batter.
Yes, as he chases outside ball one.
On that steal, it looked as if Braves catcher Alex Minton really had a hard time, you know, getting the ball and getting in position to throw.
Yeah, just kind of had like a little like hesitation on the with the communication of trying to grab the ball. As the 1-2 delivery is a grounder towards Bufkin again to Oxidine, and is out, and that ends the inning.
One runner left on base, one hit and no runs scored, no errors as well, and we'll be right back.
And we are back here at Cox Field. Bottom of the second for the Braves, up to bat. One bat leading off for the Braves is Hayden Bufkin. If you did not tune into yesterday's game, Bufkin hit the clutch off hit for the Braves walk off single to left field. I mean, that was a huge play. He's got a lot of momentum going into this game, as well as you have Stabell Almansaba batting 600. I mean, that could be a deadly. This could be a huge opportunity for the Braves.
I feel like this is a good opportunity for the Braves to, if they don't score, at least get a couple hits, a couple people on base, and maybe that will get everything rolling for the Braves and give them some momentum.
Yes, Bufkin batting 375 as he takes the first pitch for strike one.
Bufkin's batting 375, 32 at-bats, 10 runs, 12 hits, 2 doubles, and 1 home run, and 4 RBIs.
As he takes another pitch, ball 1, count moving to 1-1, you know, 4 RBIs, you know, early in the year, he's definitely, you know, had that like clutch moment like we mentioned earlier, one of those RBIs being from last night's game. You know, huge win against the Falcons, who were on a 5-game winning streak to kind of end that as the 1-1 delivery. Is another ball count moving to 2-1. I mean, that is a huge, huge play at the end of the game. Aaron McGree doing the 2-1 delivery. Bufkin waiting again. Count moving to 3-1 in the favor of the Braves. Braves doing an excellent job at the plate discipline so far in this game. Really haven't swung at really bad pitches, I would say. Just they've either hit contact or they've just barely missed the pitch. I mean, they've really done an excellent job of just waiting for their correct pitch as the 3-1 delivery is underway. As a foul backed right, count moving the full 3-2, no outs. McGree looking to put it away here. Another 1-2-3 inning, full count delivery. Little chopper towards McGree. Throw to Walker in time, out for out number one as Bufkin grounds out for the first out of the inning.
That brings to the plate for the Braves left fielder number 11, Stabell Almansaba, who is leading the Braves clearly in batting average, batting 600, 15 at-bats, 2 runs, 9 hits, 1 double, 1 triple, 1 home run, and 6 RBIs. This is somebody who the Braves really depend on to get on base, whether it be a walk or, you know, a single. This is somebody that the Braves need to get on base all the time.
Speaking of on base, his on-base percentage is .647. I mean, that's a really high statistic right now early in the year as his first pitch is a fly towards Wagner, left field. Wagner there to make the routine grab for out number two. Up next, we have the only freshman on the batting order this evening, Daniel Oxendine, first baseman. You know, for a batting order with 6 juniors, I mean, that is a big shoes to fill in, you know, to come into this Braves lineup his first year and just, you know, be on the order. It takes a lot, especially with the Braves, you know, 7-0, ranked 6th in the nation right now. I mean, that's a huge step up for him.
Daniel Oxendine has seen a few games where he's come in, not started, but come in later on in the game, and he's had a few hits, very timely hits, to move runners around to help the Braves get in scoring position.
Yes, as Oxendine fouls the first pitch back, count moving to 0-1. Looks like Oxendine's going to talk over to the third base coach.
Looked as if maybe he got hit, too, whenever he swung and hit it. He was holding his hand whenever he went down, and now he's rubbing his leg. So I'm not sure if he tweaked something on his first swing or what happened.
Yes, the trainers are out there right now. In the meantime, if you're never unable to attend the games or watch our live broadcast, make sure you guys, you know, tune in, follow us on Twitter at UNCP_sports and use the hashtag BraveNation for all updates. You know, cheering the Braves on. When I'm in the library and unable to attend these games, I usually look at the Twitter, see what's up to, see what baseball's playing. I know basketball's away today. Just seeing the Brave Nation, just be supportive of our Brave Nation while they're away.
Daniel Oxendine is still talking with the athletic trainer. Something must have happened on his first at bat.
It looks like Aaron McCree just going to have a little pep talk with Jacob Whiting. As you know, the injuries, you know, it looks like a little more severe than anticipated. If the trainers are still out there, you know, he's still on his feet. It looks like they're looking at his hand now. They might be taping it up. And
yeah, I think they just brought some tape out. Maybe tape his wrist.
Or tape fingers together if his finger got jammed or bruised. Looks like he is not going to be going back into the box. However, the Braves coaches are getting together to figure out who they could put in. I mean, the Braves got, you know, they got a huge list to choose from. You know, some players that could play in the previous game. You know, they could put in Christian Snyder, Luke Jackson, Nick Salisbury, C.J. White. Those are, you know, some guys that might be able to fill in the position for the Braves. Yes, as Nick Salisbury is up to play in the previous game. He did sub in as a pinch hitter as well for Stabel Almansaba in the previous game. As the count still remains 0-1 with two outs. The 0-1 delivery. Salisbury taking his first pitch of his of this at bat. Count moving to 1-1. As the 1-1 delivery now is 2-1, you know, doing an excellent job coming in and just waiting for his correct pitch.
Nick Salisbury has seen action in 7 games and has been up to bat 4 times.
As the count moving to 2-2 now. A little people, a little controversial, but I mean, the umpire is right there. You know, has definitely have the better vision than us here in the stands. As the count moves to 2-2 with two outs, no runners on base. Braves still looking for their first hit of the game. Strike 3.
No runners left on base. No hits. No errors. And no runs scored. We'll be right back.
And we are back here at Cox Field, bottom of the second.
With Daniel Oxendine going out, that required a shift on the Braves' defense. We now have Nick Salisbury at third base. Hayden Bufkin moved from third base.
Correction, top of the third. Looks like it's back up to the top of the order. Daniel Pardo struck out at his, got hit by a pitch in his first at bat and got caught stealing later in the second at bat as the 1-0 delivery is now a 1-1 count for the Braves. One-oh delivery, fly ball to right field, foul. This count moves to 1-2.
That foul ball almost made it over to our softball field.
Yeah, almost, you know, kind of a little close to the cars along that side too, as there is a game over there as well for the Braves. As the 1-2 delivery is way outside for ball two, count moving to 2-2. Lane Johnson, 2-2 delivery, looking to put him away. Fly ball to center field. Looks like Pierce is going to be there for the routine grab. Good hustle by Pierce and awareness by Pierce to catch the first out of the inning.
The shortstop, Dane Hutchin.
So as we were saying, when the inning first started, Daniel Oxendine had to go out after his first swing at his first at bat. That moved Drew Beaver over from second base to third base, Hayden Bufkin from third base to first base, and Nick Salisbury into second base.
Up next we have Dane Hutchin. First at bat of the first pitch is his first strike. Oh, count moving to 0-1. Dane Hutchin flew out to Alamon Saba in the first inning over at left field. You know, still looking for their second hit of the game. You know, only one hit in the game so far. And the count moves to 1-1. Lane Johnson, 1-1 delivery. A little outside, count moves to 2-1.
I believe this is the first batter that Lane Johnson's had to work from behind in the count for, so this will be nice to see how he works with a little adversity as well.
Yes, a little challenge for him as the 2-1 delivery is underway. A little high, count moves to 3-1. You know, not the most comfortable position. This is probably, you know, one of the first situations that he has not really been ahead in the count, you know. Let's see how he can bounce back as the count moves. As the count is 3-1, with one out. The 3-1 delivery. Another ball to Pierce, unable to get the catch, as the second hit of the game for the for the Falcons.
Designated hitter Jeremy Hyde.
Now coming up to bat for the Falcons, we have the designated hitter Jeremy Hyde, who walked at his first at bat. One out, runner on first base.
Yes, Jeremy Hyde was able to move to second base as well in the first inning after the back-to-back walks by Lane Johnson, as the count is now 1-0. Jeremy Hyde doing an excellent job at the plate, waiting for the correct pitch and waiting for the right opportunity to take a swing.
Lane Johnson once again checking the runner at first.
Lane Johnson doing a lot of, you know, checking, you know, definitely making sure the Falcons stay on their feet over at first base. I mean, he's had at least over 10 checks over at first base in this game so far. A little high, count moves to 2-0.
Lane Johnson really needs to throw a strike right now.
Yes, as he's been back-to-back behind the count as the 2-0 delivery is underway. First strike for Lane Johnson of this at-bat. Count moving to 2-1. As the 2-1 delivery is underway. A little close to the knees, count moving to 3-1. Again, Lane Johnson, this inning so far has not really been confident in his pitch has really just been all behind the count. You know, in the first two innings, you kind of saw him being ahead in the count more of the times than behind the count. So, I mean, you know, he's looking to keep that to regain his composure as the runner takes off. That's ball 4. Jeremy Hyde walked again for the second time of the game. Taylor Walker up to bat, got walked in the previous at-bat in the first inning.
Looks as if Braves catcher Alex Minton is going out and just to maybe try to settle down Lane Johnson, you know, get him back in the zone and really let him focus in. One out right now.
Yes, Taylor Walker, the junior, batting 5.56. You know, one guy, you know, especially with a runner in scoring position on second, you know, it's definitely, you know, one of the guys you want to be a little bit careful with, you know, could be a threat, as well as, you know, they might try to pull off a double steal, as both players have each gotten a steal so far in the season. As Lane Johnson... First pitch is ball 1. One no delivery. Fouled back for cap moving to 2-1. Or excuse me, 1-1. As looks like catcher Alex Minton giving Lane Johnson the pitch call. Lane Johnson looking over at second. One delivery. Count moves to 1-2. Lane Johnson looking to put away here in the bottom or top of the third. 1-2 delivery. Hitting the dirt. Count moving to 2-2.
Nice block by catcher Alex Minton. That ball gets past him. You know, runners advance and are in scoring position.
Yes, that could have been a very deadly encounter for the Braves. You know, but preventing that is definitely a good play by Alex Minton. Johnson 2-2 delivery. Hitting the center field, pushing through the gap. Runner coming home. Looks like Pierce, no throw by Pierce as the Falcons move up 1-0 in the game.
That brings up to bat second baseman Matthew Ferruto, who struck out looking his last time at bat.
Yes, as the bases are still one first, one out. Runners on first and second. Ferruto has not really, you know, he did strike out in the first inning, but, you know, that momentum of the run scored could definitely, you know, put Ferruto in a little bit, can change the momentum of the game for the Falcons. As Furuto's first pitch is ball one, count moving to 1-0. As umpire Ryan Combs calls time. Matthew Fruta just stepping out of the box for a moment. One out delivery. Ball low. Count moving to 2-0. Delivery, moving to 3-0, ball low and outside.
This is the first batter that Lane Johnson has been this far behind, and, you know, once it got to 2-1 in previous at-bats, he would throw a strike or the batter would foul it off and help him out, but, you know, this is the farthest he's been behind since the game started.
Indeed. Unable to just regain his composure at a 3-0 pitch. His count moving to 3-1. A little hesitant on the call by home plate umpire Ryan Combs. Three-one delivery, ball four. As now the bases are loaded.
Brings up left fielder Chad Wagner. Last time at bat, he had a ground ball to third base and was thrown out at first.
Lane Johnson's fourth walk of the game, as looks like head coach of the Braves coming out just to kind of try to calm down Lane Johnston.
The softball scoreboard update from LRA Field, game 1.0, UNCP 3, Glenville State 2.
Correction, pitching coach Daniel Britt out there talking to Lane Johnson. Trying to figure out what to do in this type of situation with bases loaded. Bases loaded for the Falcons, one out. As Wagner takes the first pitch, high and inside, count moving to 1-0. You know, definitely not one, you know, not a position that Lane Johnson feels comfortable in. You know, doing a really good job in the first two innings, only giving up one hit. But this third inning has definitely just been not his correct inning for him, as he throws another ball, count moving to 2-0.
He already has four walks in three innings right now, and this would be a critical situation for him not to have another walk, and he really needs to settle in, focus on the batter, and let his defense behind him help him.
Absolutely. No, this could be the perfect opportunity for the Braves as well to ground into a double play or a liner. As a 2-0 delivery is underway. Count moving to 3-0. Not again. Lane Johnson just unable to. This is the second time in this inning that he's had three pitches, three balls. And he's got to throw a strike at this point. I mean, basically, if he throws another ball, it would be a 2-0 game in favor of the Falcons. So the 3-0 delivery is underway. As four pitches, four balls.
That draws the fifth walk that Montevallo has received, scoring one run. So that score is now 2-0, one out, base is still loaded. Alex Minton, catcher for the Braves, going out to talk to right-handed pitcher Lane Johnson. Head coach Paul O'Neill coming out to the mound. Looks as if the Braves, you know, might be making a pitching change. There's some action in the Braves bullpen right now. Maybe Paul O'Neill just wants to talk with the whole team and come up with a new plan, but it looks as if the day for Lane Johnson is over.
Yes, an unfortunate, not the greatest start that he particularly wanted. Did really, really strong in this first two innings, you know, giving up only one hit. But the third inning has really been tough. He's faced almost the entire order, seven batters so far. In this third inning alone, he's given up one single, two walks.
And it looks as if right-handed pitcher sophomore number 51, Trace Hagler, will be taking the mound for the Braves.
Trace Hagler, the sophomore out of Kannapolis, North Carolina. We will be right back. And we are back here. The offensive change for the Braves. The sophomore, Trace Hagler, pitching in from Kannapolis, North Carolina. You know, so definitely a young gun here for the Braves. You know, could definitely be, you know, what they, that little spark that the defense need for the Braves to get them out of this unfortunate inning. Two runs have scored just on walks. One run on a single to center field.
Trace Hagler has seen action in two games, two innings pitched. He's given up three hits, one run, and he struck out three batters.
Hagler throwing his first pitch is a ball one, count moving 1-0. One out, bases still loaded here in the top of the third inning. As it looks like a fly ball to Debo, back
deep fly ball
hitting the wall. One, two. Looks like two runners are going to score here, and the count and score moves to 4-0 in favor of the Falcons. Looks like Ferruto and Walker both score on that play. Up next, we have the catcher, Jacob Whiting, who struck out in the second inning of this game. But that could definitely change for him as, you know, the Falcons have a 4-0 lead.
There's a lot of momentum right now on the Falcons side.
Hagler definitely needs to, you know, just kind of shake that off. It's just, you know, unfortunate first at bat, but definitely has the momentum to continue as both runners are in scoring position. First pitch for Whiting. His count moves to 0-1, swing and a miss.
Runners at second and third, one out, count 0-1.
O-1 delivery fouled back over the stands. Count moves to 0-2 in favor of the sophomore.
This is a great position right now for Trace Hagler and a very big out that the Braves need right now.
Yes, after giving up a two-run double, count moving to 0-2. 0-2 delivery hitting the dirt, count moving to 1-2. Hagler looking to put it, Trace Hagler putting it away. Fouled back, staying alive here at this at bat against the sophomore. Count still 1-2, both runners in scoring position. As a 0-1-2 delivery pop up towards Debo, runner tagging up. Another runner scores for the Falcons as the score moves to 5-0.
Third baseman, Chase Bryant.
And it looked as if Dupree, moved over to third base.
Looked like Wagner scored from third on that play.
That sends to the plate, third baseman number 2.
Chase Bryant taking the first pitch for a strike count. Moving to 0-1, two outs, only one runner on third. Oh, 1 delivery, count moving to 1-1. Count moving to 1-2-1. Almost at the top of the order for the Falcons, going through the whole team in just one inning. Definitely not the most positive thing for the Braves going on right now. Just having a hard time pitching and defensively as well as the 2-1 delivery is underway. Little high, count moves to 3-1. Delivery. Strike two, count moving the full count, 3-2, two outs, runner on third. Trace Hagler looking to end this long inning for the Braves. You know, definitely could be a possible momentum ending on a strikeout to put them back into a contention ball game. 3-2 delivery. Strike three as the Braves finally end the side.
One runner left on base. 5 runs, 4 hits, and no errors. We'll be right back.
And we are back here at Cox Field, located on the campus of UNCP. As it looks like Nolan Pierce up to leading off for the Braves here in the bottom of the third. Kind of recapping from the top of the third. Tough inning for the Braves as five runs were scored. I mean, Lane Johnson was taken out. Just really could not find the plate in the third inning, even though doing a successful job in the first and second. As the first pitch for Pierce hits him in the shoulder as he takes first base.
The Braves are coming up on the end of their lineup. You know, this inning, they could possibly see the top of the lineup again. But, you know, that was Nolan Pierce's first at bat. You know, it's weird to say that because I feel like Montevallo has already been to bat multiple times, you know. That was a very big inning for them. They batted through the lineup. So this brings to bat number 25, the catcher, Alex Mitten.
Mitten batting 286 on the season, entering the game, 14 at-bats, 4 hits. 2 of those hits have been done, so you know, definitely got a little bit of speed behind him and 3 RBIs. As the first pitch for Mitten is a little bit of a check swing, but pulls back for ball 1.
Yesterday, Mitten, came in, had 2 at-bats. Really, nothing exciting happened yesterday in his at-bat.
Another check swing by Mitten. Count moving, but even though called strike, count moving to 1-1. No outs, runner on base, first base. One delivery, count moving to 2-1. Hit, made contact, fouled the back. Count moving to 2-2. You know, definitely the opportunity for the Braves to try to counter that long inning for the Falcons. Just 5 runs on 4 hits. I mean, they have the capability to do it. I mean, they're number 6 in the nation, looking to make it 8-0 of the season. That's a 2-2 delivery. Outside, count moving to full count, 3-2. No, leadoff hitter Nolan Pierce definitely, getting the hit by pitch was a little bit of a spark for the Braves. Not the, the most positive spark, but definitely to get a runner on base. As the full count pitch is ball 4, as Mitten takes base, first base.
That brings up shortstop number 2, Roberto Rivera.
Roberto Rivera went for 4 in yesterday's game, scoring 1 run and was left on base once.
Right now in the season's batting 348, 23 at-bats, 8 runs, 8 hits, 4 doubles, and 9 RBIs. So, looking at those statistics with runners at second and first with no outs, this would be a great situation for Roberto Rivera to, tack on to his statistics and the RBIs and even get another double to, help the Braves score here.
Yes, as the first pitch for Rivera is ball 1, count moving to 1-0. One runner in scoring position for the Braves, as looks like the head coach of the Falcons comes out to talk.
It was my understanding that everyone had heard.
Heard what?
Quick discussion with pitcher Aaron McGree. Didn't really just kind of got composed a little bit by pitching coach of the Falcons. With one runner in scoring position for the Braves, runners on first and second, no outs here in the bottom of the third for Rivera. As the 1-0 delivery, hitting the corner of the plate, count moves to 1-1.
Roberto Rivera is someone who is very patient at the plate. So far in the season, he's already had 5 walks.
As the 1-1 delivery fouled over by the Falcons dugout, count moving to 1-2. 1-2 delivery. Fouled over towards that right side again, this time out of play. Count remains 1-2 in favor of the Falcons.
Revere doing a nice job of protecting the plate and swinging really at anything that's close. He does not want to be called here for a strikeout.
Yes, definitely staying alive here in this at-bat. As McGree looking to put him away here in the bottom of the third. Tipped, fouled back. Count still remaining 1-2. One-two delivery. McCree looking to put him away. Count moving to 2-2. Rivera had to take a little lean back for that pitch. Runners on first and second. Still no outs here in the bottom of the third for the Braves. McCree taking a little check. No throw over towards Nolan Pierce. Count still 2-2. Two delivery fouled back again. You know, definitely staying alive. That's third pitch that he has fouled. You know, that's a huge, you know, thing in a positive like prospect. You know, a team might look for, because you know, definitely staying alive at the plate definitely, you know, kind of wears down the pitcher as well as
yeah, very, you know, lengthy at bat right now for Roberto Rivera.
Count moves to 2-2 delivery. Swing and a miss. Strike three for the first out of the inning. Moving back to the top of the order, Nick Debo struck out in the first inning here, which kind of felt like forever ago because of the third inning lasting for such a long time, going through the whole order for the Falcons. That's the first pitch for Nick. Fouled back. Count moving to 0-1. McGree almost throwing a pitch. Looks back over at Pierce for to see if anyone was there, but nobody was home for the Falcons, so no throw was made. Count still 0-1, one out. Runners on first and second. 0-1 delivery. Missing by Ferruto. One looks like Pierce is heading for home. The play at the plate. No play. Caught over at third is Mitten, who walked in the early in the inning, but one run does score. As the Braves are down by 4 runs, 5-1 here in the bottom of the third. Two outs.
And that brings up to bat now the third baseman, Drew Beaver.
Definitely, you know, a huge opportunity for the Braves, even though runner did get caught at third. Definitely, you know, a huge opportunity finally getting some momentum to come back into this game, especially what happened in the previous half inning. As Daniel Beaver taking the first pitch, fouled out of play. Count moves to 0-1. As the 0-1 delivery fouled over again towards the right side, count moving to 0-2.
in Drew Beaver's last at-bat. He had a fly ball deep towards the first baseman, very close to the Montevallo Falcons dugout.
Hickory looking to put him away. Oh, check swing. Asking for first base umpire for the check swing, and Todd Drake and calls a swing as that ends the inning.
There was one run, one hit for the Braves, and one runner left on base. We'll be right back.
And we are back here at Cox Field for the top of the fourth inning. Daniel Pardo up to bat, the junior center fielder, as he takes his first pitch. Strike one, count moving to 0-1 in favor of the Braves. Definitely need to kind of recap the bottom half of the third inning if you're just tuning in. Some momentum in for the Braves, especially what happened in the third inning as the 0-1 delivery hits the dirt, count moving to 1-1. You know, definitely kind of gave a little spark for the Braves. As the score is now 5-1 in favor of the Falcons. As the 1-1 delivery moves to 2-1 in favor of the Falcons. Two-one delivery underway by Hagler. Fly ball towards left center. Looks like a routine catch by Alman Saba for the first out of the inning. Excellent play and great hustle by Saba.
That's into the plate. Shortstop, Dane Hutchins. In his first at bat, he flew out to left field. And then at his second at-bat, he had a fly ball to center field that dropped right in front of Nolan Pierce.
As the first pitch goes past by Salisbury for the first hit of the inning for the Falcons.
Now up to bat for the Falcons, designated hitter Jeremy Hyde, who really has seen a very patient day, I would say, at the plate. Two walks on the day for Hyde.
Yes, one run in the third inning. Scored one of the runs for the Falcons in this 5-1 game. As the first pitch for Hyde is in the dirt. Count moving to 1-0. Delivery count moving to 2-0 in favor of the Falcons. Trace Hagler, the sophomore, coming in for Lane Johnston in the third inning, doing an excellent job so far, only giving up one hit. Count moving to 3-0 in favor of the Falcons. 3-0 delivery, ball four as the bases are now first and second, one out, double play opportunity for the Braves as Taylor Walker is up to bat here. Walked in the first inning and scored in the third for the Falcons.
In the third inning, Walker had a ground ball to center field.
That's the first pitch for Walker is in the dirt, count moving to 1-0. Delivery underway. Over the plate, count moving to 1-1. One out, runners on first and second. One delivery underway. Too much inside, count moving to 2-1. Walker doing an excellent job all game so far, just kind of waiting for that the correct opportunity to take a good swing at a pitch, because he walked in the first, doing an excellent job just staying alive and waiting for the correct moment as the 2-1 delivery is underway. Going past, caught by Beaver, the overthrown towards Salisbury, and Buckin for the double play to end the inning.
And we are back in the bottom of the fourth with designated hitter Justin Dottillo coming up to bat. In his first at bat in the very first inning, he had a ground ball to second base. First pitch delivery, ball.
Count moving to 1-0 as Aaron McGree doing an excellent job on the mound so far. Five going into his fourth inning, only giving up one run and one hit for the Falcons, doing an excellent job on the mound.
Count now 1-2, or 1-1, excuse me.
As that ball is hit towards center field, looks like Daniel Pardo is going to be there for the routine grab for out number one of the inning.
That's into the plate for the Braves now. First baseman Hayden Bufkin.
First baseman Hayden Bufkin.
In his first plate appearance in the second inning, he grounded out to the pitcher, so hopefully now Hayden Bufkin can really get something going and get on base.
First pitch, first swing, line drive towards Hutchins for out number two of the inning. Not the start that the Braves really, really wanted here in the bottom of the fourth inning.
Now coming to the plate, left fielder Stabell Alamansaba.
Alamansaba flew out in the second inning. No, definitely coming in with a 600 average here in this game, doing an excellent job for the Braves throughout the season as they are looking to make it 8-0 here today.
First pitch strike coming into Alamansaba. Some of the Braves fans don't really agree with that call.
Yes, just putting out their opinion towards home plate umpire.
Count now moving to one ball, one strike. Two outs and no runners on base.
Yeah, it looks like the home plate umpire definitely returning a favor. Ryan Combs returning a favor for the fans as the first one. 1-1 delivery. Liner over Ferruto's mitt as the second hit of the Braves comes in from Bufkin.
Now coming up to bat, second baseman Nick Salisbury.
Correction, Alamansaba.
Salisbury.
First pitch, first swing, ball towards right field. Dupree hustling over there. Unable to make the catch as looks like Saba is heading home. A stand-up sliding triple for the Braves as now the score is 5-2. Huge momentum for Salisbury coming into the game, pitch hitting and able to get that diving triple.
That really seemed to spark a lot of momentum out of Braves dugout. I mean, I know there's two outs, but you know, now with a runner on third. Coming up to bat is center fielder Nolan Pitch, who was in his last at bat hit by a pitch. So, you know, really looking to keep this rolling two-out rally going for the Braves.
First hit of the season for Salisbury as he comes into this game. Big stand-up, big play for the Braves with two outs. First pitch, first swing again, looking towards Hutchman, over throwing towards Walker for the third out of the game.
So for the Braves, there was one hit, one run scored, no errors, and we will be right back. And we are back with Montevallo sending to the plate second baseman Matthew Ferruto.
First pitch, first swing, moves past Beaver for the first hit of the inning.
Very hard ground ball hit past third baseman Drew Beaver. Now up to bat for the Falcons, left fielder Chad Wagner. First pitch from Trace Hagler, outside for ball one.
Fly ball towards center field. Nolan Pierce hustling over to make the catch for out number one of the inning. Great hustle by Nolan Pierce.
The right fielder, Colin
Dupuy. Now up to bat, Colin Dupuy.
Dupuy, had a double in the previous at bat in the third inning and also a stolen base in the second. First pitch, first swing towards Rivera. Over towards Salisbury, looking for the double play to Bufkin for the double play is connected.
And that is two double plays for the Braves to end the last inning and this inning.
Great sparks for the Braves, and we will be right back.
Welcome back. We are in the bottom of the fifth inning, and for the Braves coming up to bat, we have catcher Alex Minton.
Kind of recapping the top of the fifth inning. Really quick inning for the Braves defense as they were able to have back-to-back double plays to end the inning here in this game so far. Great spark, guys, especially down, being down 5-2 here in this game.
You know, this is only Alex Minton's second at-bat of this whole game, and the first at-bat he had a walk.
Yes, that walk occurring in the third inning. McGree, first pitch fouled back, hitting the fence. Count moving to 0-1. 0-1 delivery. Fouled over. count moving 0-2.
The 0-2 pitch coming.
This looks like it's grounded towards Hutch and thrown over to Walker for the routine put out as the first out of the inning.
That sends to the plate shortstop Roberto Rivera. His first at bat in the third inning, strikeout.
Yes, Roberto Rivera looking for his first hit of the game. Looking to get some spark going for the Braves here in the bottom of the fifth.
First pitch, ball one. Foul ball. Count moving to 1-1. Another foul ball, count moving to 1-2, one out, no runners on base. Roberto Rivera up to bat for the Braves.
Aaron McCree looking, trying to put him away there, count moving to 2-2. Pitch in the dirt, thrown over towards Walker for the second out of the inning.
And strikeout looking for Roberto Rivera. That sends to the plate right fielder, number 20, Nick Debo. His first at bat, he struck out looking. And in his second at bat in the third inning, he had a ground ball to right field to get him on first base. Two outs, no runners on base for the Braves. First pitch, strike one.
First, second, splitting the gap between first and third baseman for the single four. Nick Debo.
Another ground ball to right field for Debo. That sends to the plate for the Braves. Number 16, third baseman, Drew Beaver.
Third baseman, Drew Beaver.
Two outs, runner on first. In Beaver's two previous at-bats, in the first inning, he had a fly ball deep to the first baseman, and at his second at-bat, in the third inning, he had strikeout looking. First pitch, high for ball one. Pitch two, fouled off back behind the catcher. Count moving to 1-1.
Looks like a liner over Chase Bryant's head. Easy single for the Braves. One runner moves into scoring position for the Braves. As a big two-out hit for the Braves. Up next, we have Justin Dottillo, designated hitter.
looks as if McGree and Whiting are having just a little conversation, you know, maybe Whiting telling him just to settle down a little. This is a good position for the Braves, you know, runners in scoring position. Although there are two outs, almost seems as if the Braves work better under two outs. A little pressure added.
Yes, definitely had a lot of momentum plays off two outs here in this ball game.
Designated hitter Justin Dottillo up to bat. In his first at bat, he had a ground out to the second baseman. And in his third at bat, in the fourth inning, he had a fly ball to center field for another out. First pitch delivered. A little bit of a check swing for strike one. Runners on first and second, not really taking too big of a lead. Second pitch, fly ball over to the right side, out of play. Count moving to 0-2.
O2 delivery, swing and miss for out number three of the inning. We will be right back at the top of the sixth inning.
And we are back in the top of the sixth inning. Montevallo Falcons lead UNC Pembroke Braves 5-2. Trace Hagler still out on the mound for the Braves. He's entering his third inning of work right now. Coming up to bat for Montevallo is number 8, catcher Jacob Whiting. Hasn't really had too big of a day, you know. Struck out looking the first at bat, and he had a fly ball to right field for a second out in the second inning.
But yes, that sack fly did bring home a run for the Falcons, so really positive outcome on that at bat.
First pitch delivery from Hagler. Strike one. Second pitch, fouled off. Count moving to 0-2. Hagler's really attacking this first batter, you know, getting ahead. Hopefully he can stay ahead in it as well. Pitch number 3, count moving to 1-2. Pitch number 4 was a ball, so count is now 2-2. Again, some of the Braves fans did not agree with that call.
Definitely expressing their opinion to home plate umpire Ryan Combs as the 2-2 delivery. Swing and a miss for out number 1 of the inning. Great pitch. by Trace Hagler.
And that's Hagler's first strikeout of his debut here for the Braves in this game. Now up to bat, third baseman number two, Chase Bryant. Had a ground out to third baseman and a strikeout looking. First pitch high from Trace Hagler, ball one. Count now 1-1.
As the 1-1 delivery fouls over right, hitting the light post and jumping back into play.
Count is now 1-2, one out and no runners on base.
One-two delivery fly ball towards Saba, able to make the routine grab for out number two.
That ball was hit, you know, right to the warning track, but Saba, Aleman Saba had no problem with that for out number two.
Up next for the Falcons,
center fielder Daniel Pardo. First pitch fouled back behind for strike one.
Daniel Pardo got hit by a pitch in the first inning. Was able to go on base, but unable to continue that by flying out in the third and fourth inning here in this game so far. A one delivery fly ball to right field over towards
Nick Debo. Very far, and it is over the fence. So that is a home run for center fielder Daniel Pardo.
What a shot by Daniel Pardo. As the score now moves 6-2 in favor of the Falcons.
That sends to the plate shortstop Dane Hutchin. So far on the day for Hutchin, he had a fly out to left field in the first inning. Third inning had a fly ball to center field that dropped in front of Nolan Pierce to allow him to get on base, and a ground ball to right field in the fourth inning to allow him to get on base as well. Pitch number one from Trace Hagler, strike one. Pitch number two outside, ball one. So count is now 1-1 with two outs.
One delivery, another ball towards right field, this time out of play towards foul territory. Count moving to 1-2.
There have been a lot of foul balls this game and a lot of deep fly balls this game.
Yes, definitely, you know.
From both teams, really.
A scary factor for both teams when you see the ball kind of hitting towards that outfield wall as the 1-2 delivery is underway.
Ball in the dirt, count moving to 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs.
Trace Hackler definitely doing a good job shaking off that previous at-bat, looking to put away the side here in this inning.
Low pitch, full count.
Yeah.
fly ball back behind the catcher out of play. Count still 3-2. You know, a strikeout here or an out here would really be good for Trace Hagler, like as you said, to shake off the home run at the previous at-bat.
As Trace Hagler looking to put away here in this happening full count delivery. Swing and a miss, and that puts out another K for Hagler. We will be right back.
And we are back in the bottom of the sixth inning. Braves sending to the plate first baseman, number 9, Hayden Bufkin.
First pitch, first swing, fouled. Count moving to 0-1.
Hayden Bufkin really looking to get something started for him today. First at-bat in the second inning, grounded out to the pitcher. And his second at-bat in the fourth inning had a line drive to the shortstop for a second out. Second pitch in the dirt for a ball, count 1-1. McGree still on the mound for the Falcons. Pitch number 3 for a strike. Count now 1-2. McGree has had an excellent day on the mound for the Falcons. They've gotten a great outing out of him.
Yes, going into his sixth inning really strong. Doesn't look like he's slowing down any at all. 1-2 delivery fouled out of play. Count still remains 1-2.
They could not ask for a better outing out of him. He really, and like you said, does not look tired.
Bufkin doing an excellent job staying alive here at this at-bat here in the bottom of the sixth inning. As a grounder towards Hutchman, overthrow towards Walker to put out Bufkin for the first out of the inning.
That sends to the plate for the Braves left fielder, number 11, Sabel Alimansaba. In his first at bat in the second inning, had a fly out to left field. And in his second at-bat in the fourth inning, had a line drive to the right fielder to get his first hit of the day. First pitch, low and outside for a ball 1. Pitch number 2 fouled off back behind the catcher and out of play, strike one.
Fly ball towards left field, over towards Wagner, hustling over.
And it is in fair territory.
Good placement by Alamon Saba to get on base here in the bottom of the sixth. Up next,
second baseman Nick Salisbury.
Salisbury getting a triple early in the game in the fourth inning, definitely creating some spark for the Braves.
Big RBI for Salisbury. One out, runner at first base.
Hit directly to the pitcher.
With an overthrow from McCree.
McCree with a wild throw. Really good placement, really good awareness by him to react to that ball very quickly, but just unable to connect over towards second
that
base.
That puts Alamon Saba on second and Nick Salisbury on first. Hard hit ball. Well, very hard hit ball back towards the pitcher. And that brings to the plate for the Braves center fielder number 12, Nolan Pierce. Nolan Pierce has had a good day, you know. Started off getting hit by a pitch, probably not how he really wanted to start the day. And then at his second at bat, he had a ground ball to the shortstop. And that really kept the inning going, or really started the inning for the Braves. Looks now as if little chat in the infield for catcher and McGree for the Falcons.
And Chad Whiting.
One out, runner at second and first for the Braves with Nolan Pierce at the plate. First pitch delivered, strike one. Second pitch in the dirt, kept in front of the catcher, though, which was a good thing, or Braves runners would have been on the move. Count now 1-1.
One delivery just hitting, missing that third baseline, count moving to 1-2. One, two delivery, strike three, two outs.
That brings to the plate for the Braves catcher, number 25, Alex Minton.
Alamon Saba and Salisbury. Alamon Saba on second base, Salisbury on first. Alex Minton looking to put Alamon Saba at home plate to make the game 6-3.
Braves really need to capitalize on having runners on base at this point in the game. First pitch delivery, fouled out of play for strike one.
A one delivery hit towards Ferruto. Taking the grounder over towards Taylor Walker for the third out of the game. or inning, excuse me.
Two runners left on base, one error, and we will be right back. Welcome back. We are in the top of the seventh inning. Montevallo Falcons leading the UNC Pembroke Braves 6-2. There's been a defensive change for the Braves. Now pitching is number 22, sophomore right-handed pitcher Justin Pegram. Pegram has seen action in three games this year. He's started one game. He's pitched six innings so far. Coming up to bat for the Falcons in the top of the seventh inning is designated hitter number 28, Jeremy Hyde. Hyde has had, he's been on base every time he's been at to bat, and he has not had to hit the ball yet. He has had three walks so far.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, definitely a huge patience there as he takes another patient pitch for ball number one.
Strike one.
Correction, strike one.
Pitch number two high for ball one. Delivery from Pegram hit hard to the shortstop.
Going by past Rivera for the first hit of the inning for the Falcons.
Now up to bat, first baseman Taylor Walker.
Pitch advance, pitch running at first base for Montevallo, number 9, Thomas Brady.
The Falcons have put in a pinch runner at first base, so now running is number 9, Thomas Brady. Walker on the day so far has had a walk, a ground ball to center field, and a ground out into a double play. Oh, First pitch from Pegram is a strike. High fly ball over towards the first base, and it is out of play. Strike two.
Bufkin doing an excellent job hustling over towards that foul ball, but out of play, unable to make the grab.
O2 delivery from Pegram. Inside. Ball one. Count is now 1-2. Walker thought he got hit on that.
Yeah, definitely a little close. Kind of, you know, might have skipped the jersey a little bit, but
didn't make any effort really to get out of the way of it either.
Runner takes off. Ball towards left field line.
Staying in fair play. Looks as if a runner is going to score. It's a stand-up double and an RBI for Taylor Walker with Jeremy Hyde scoring.
Scored now 7-2 in favor of the Falcons still here in this ball game. Still two innings left to play. Two and a half, or technically three batting opportunities for the Braves here in this ball game.
That's into the plate for the Falcons. Second baseman, Matthew Ferruto. No outs, runner at second. Bust. Squares around a bunt.
And fair
stays fair right on the line. Looked as if Alex Mitten thought it was going to be foul, and so did Ferruto.
Yeah, Ferruto kind of a little hesitant, didn't know where the ball exactly was located, but able to get that sacrifice bunt to move that runner on third base 90 feet away from scoring position.
That's into the plate, left fielder Chad Wagner. The Braves have moved their infielders in. First pitch is thrown in from Pegram as a strike. Second pitch fouled off. Count now 0-2 with one out and runner on third base. Chad Wagner was just hit and looked as if he was hitting the hand and wrist area. And the trainers immediately went out there to him. He is in a lot of pain. It looks as if Chad Wagner will stay in the game and he will not be exiting. And that's into the plate right fielder Colin Dupuy. Runners on first and third with one out.
Runner on first base takes the steal. No throw at all. No vision of it as both runners are now in scoring position. Count 1-0.
And it looked as if Dupree was going to try to square around a bunt and pulled back.
Look for a possible hit and run opportunity.
Runners there. Now on second and third. 1-0 count with one out.
No different fly ball left field. Looks left of the foul line. Count moving to 1-1.
Ball bouncing in the dirt, kept in front of catcher Alex Minton. Count is now 2-1.
Alex Minton doing an excellent job blocking at the plate. That could have definitely forced a run and putting that runner on second base over towards third.
Ball fouled off over to the right side. Count stays 2-2.
Delivery. Rivera unable to make the grab. One runner scores. Third runner on third base now. Third base coach telling him to hold as the score is now 8-2. Still in favor of the Falcons.
That now puts runners on first and third with one out still. It looks as if head coach for the Braves, Paul O'Neill, is making a trip out to the mound. Possible pitching change. And it looks as if the day for Justin Pegram is over. Now coming in to pitch for the Braves is number 43, right-handed pitcher senior, Tyler Holt. And we will be right back.
Whiting. Yeah.
And we are back, and there's been a defensive change for the Braves. Now pitching is number 43, Tyler Holt. Coming to the plate for the Falcons is catcher Jacob Whiting. Runners on first and third for the Falcons with one out. First pitch from Holt of the day is good for a strike. Count 0-1. Holt looking and throwing back at first base, keeping the runner at first very honest.
First base runner takes off. Throw back towards third. No tag at all, but both runners now in scoring position. The third base runner kind of hesitated on the play, kind of leaned, was out a little bit more off the bag than anticipated.
Count 0-2 for Jacob Whiting. Still one out for the Braves. The Braves really need an out here. Hard line drive up the or through the shortstop and third baseman, scores one run. Score is now 9-2 with runners at first and third and one out. And that's into the plate for the Falcons third baseman Chase Bryant. First pitch from Holt, the ball. Pitch two is outside for ball number two.
Alex Benton with the throw over towards Bufkin. No tag. Count moving to 2-1. The Braves definitely do have a double play opportunity here in the bottom of the seventh to end this inning with the 2-1 delivery underway. Fly ball towards Debo. Nick Debo over there looks like to make the catch.
Foul territory, yeah.
Throw to second. Is it in time? Little off the plate as one runner does score to make the score 10-2 here in the top of the seventh.
Two outs now, sending to the plate for the Falcons center fielder Daniel Pardo. In Pardo's last at bat, he had a home run. First pitch, first strike from Tyler Holt. Mm-hmm. Pitch number two is another strike, so count is now 0-2 with two outs and a runner on second.
Tyler Holt definitely looking to put away Daniel Pardo here in the top of the seventh to end this inning. It looks like home plate umpire Ryan Combs calls time slightly. Must have saw something. O2 delivery foul fly ball towards Almas Saba, making the catch to end the inning. We will be right back.
And we are back in the bottom of the seventh inning. Montevallo Falcons leading UNC Pembroke Braves 10-2. Up to bat is shortstop Roberto Rivera. Rivera's only had two at-bats for today. One of them was a strikeout swinging. Second one, strikeout looking. So, you know, this would be the time now that the Braves really need to capitalize and focus on getting on base, getting runners in scoring position, and piecing things together.
Yeah.
Really get something going here. Get the ball rolling for him. Pitch number one from McGree, who is still on the mound in the seventh inning for the Falcons, is a ball. Count 1-0.
As the fly ball towards right fielder. Dupree making the route, Colin Dupree making the routine grab for out number one.
That's into the plate for the Braves. Right fielder number 20, Nick Debo. Pitch number one is a ball. Count moving to 2-0 now for Nick Debo.
Fly ball towards left center field. Looks like Pardo's calling off Wagner as he makes the routine grab for out number two.
That's into the plate for the Braves, number 16, third baseman Drew Beaver. First pitch swinging for Drew Beaver. High fly ball over towards the Braves dugout. And it is caught for out number three.
Chase Bryant with the grab for out number three.
No hits, no runs, no errors for the Braves, and we will be right back. Welcome back. We are in the top of the eighth inning. There was a defensive change for the Braves. Now pitching, number 47, Chance Pauley. And up to bat for the Falcons is number 18, Dan Hutchin. First pitch swinging, high fly ball to left field, and that is out number one.
Stabell Armand Saba with the grab for out number one. Here in the top of the eighth inning, score 8-2 in favor of the Falcons. Correction, 10-2. Fly ball towards center field. It's deep. It's going back, going to the warning track. And it is over. Looks like.
Thomas Brady for his home run.
A substitution for the Falcons coming in with a big effect. As the score is now 11-2. Up next we have Taylor Walker. First pitch delivery is ball one, count moving to 1-0. One-zero delivery, hitting the dirt, count moving to 2-0. Two-zero delivery. Over the plate, count moving to 2-1. Two-one delivery, hitting the dirt, count moving to 3-1.
Pauly with a 3-1 delivery real quickly. Fly ball towards right foul right field side. Count moving to full count, 3-2. Three-two delivery is strike three.
Strikeout looking for Taylor Walker.
Up next for the Falcons, we got J.D. Miner stepping in. J.D. Miner played third base last game, if you missed. Did not have a hit, however. Played really defensively in the previous game. As the first pitch is a ball. Count moving to 1-0. Two outs, no runners left on base. 11-2 in favor of the Falcons. As the count now moves to 2-0. As the 2-0 pitch hit towards Rivera, overthrow towards Bufkin. It is out, and that ends the inning. One home run in the game, no runners left on base, no errors for the Braves, and we will be right back. And we are back here at Coxfield for bottom of the eight Peach Belt Conference action between the Falcons and the Braves. Scores 11-2 in favor of the Falcons. Up we have Justin Dottillo, the designated hitter for the Braves this evening. Came into the game batting .481. As the first pitch delivery is underway, little low, count moving to 1-0 in favor of the Braves. Pitcher Aaron McGree going for the completed game here today. 8 strong innings so far here in this ball game, not holding back, only giving up 2 runs and 6 hits in 8 innings pitched. As the count moves to 2-0. The 2-0 delivery underway. Over the plate, count moving to 2-1, 0 outs, no runners left on base. One delivery underway. Over the plate again, count moving to 2-2, evening the count for the Braves. The 2-2 delivery, McCree looking to put him away. Count moving to full count, 3-2. Justin Dottillo doing an excellent job at the plate with the plate vision, waiting for the correct pitches to come his way to swing. As the full count delivery, McCree looking to put him away.
Oh my God.
Strike three as out number one. A lot of the fans,
That's awful.
Little questionable on that play. Looked like Justin Datilla was threw his back towards his dugout, looking to go walking over towards first, but umpire Ryan Combs called strike three.
First baseman Hayden Foxing.
Up next, we have the first baseman Hayden Bufkin was originally playing third base but switched over towards first as he takes the first pitch, strike one. 0-1 count, one out, no runners left on base here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Oh, one delivery for McCree. Swing and a miss, count moving to 0-2. Oh, 2 delivery. McCree looking to put him away here. Swing and a miss, strike three. Three pitches, three strikes, two outs now. Here in the bottom of the eighth, the Braves just unable to get any momentum going here in this ever since the fourth inning. But up next we have Stabell Amonsaba, who's done an excellent job playing defensively, going for every ball he can that's in his territory out in left field and grabbing it. Coming into the game with a .600 average. Has had two singles in this game so far. The first pitch delivery is ball one, count moving to 1-0, two outs.
It's the eighth inning.
Delivery underway. Staba over the pitcher as Alamon Staba gets the first hit of this inning for the Braves. Looking for the Braves to have another two-out hit here in this ballgame. They've had a lot of opportunities to capitalize on two outs. They've done an excellent job, but just unable to capitalize into runs. As Nick Salisbury substituted in earlier, playing second base, hit his first hit of the season as a triple, diving triple here in this ball game. As the count is outside, count moving to 1-0. That's the 1-0 delivery. Outside again, count moving to 2-0. McCree, 2-0 delivery underway. Is a little grounder towards Hutchin for out number three. No runners, or one runner left on base, no one hit, no Falcon error. We will be right back. And we are back here on Cox Field, located on the campus of UNCP. Pinch hitter Dominic DeVell in for the Falcons. As the score is now is 11-2 in favor of the Falcons. Braves unable to have really any momentum into this game. Throughout the game, they've had two good innings of in the third and fourth, one run coming in from both of those innings.
And we are back here for the bottom of the ninth action. Up next, for the Braves, we have a pinch hitter, Nick Hayes, stepping in. Junior usually typically plays outfielder, but is pinch hitting for the Braves. Here at the bottom of the ninth, looking to get some momentum going here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Score 11-2 in favor of the Falcons. As the first pitch delivery is strike one, count moving to 0-1. Aaron McCree has pitched throughout the whole game, looking to go for the completed game here against the Braves. As the 0-1 delivery is underway. Just too much inside, count moving to 1-1. One delivery from McCree is a fly ball towards left field. Unfortunately, foul. Count moves to 1-2 in favor of the Falcons. McCree doing an excellent job for the Falcons, holding down the pitching, only giving up two runs on seven hits. Had earlier in the game, but was able to recover and bounce back. As the 1-2 delivery is underway, McCree looking to put him away. Is a grounder towards Ferruto, over towards Taylor Walker for the first out of the inning. The Falcons are two outs away from ending the game. Up next, we have another pinch hitter, Wiley Jackson, the senior. Typically plays catcher, but is pinch hitting for the Braves here.
Pitcher 45, Wiley Jackson.
Looks like Coach Paul Neal looking for their big sluggers here in the bottom of the ninth as the first pitch delivery is strike one in favor of the Falcons. Count moves to 0-1. Delivery. Another strike. Count 0-2. Wiley Jackson really unhappy with the location choice of these pitches, not taking a swing at any of them. McCree looking to put him away. Swing, miss, over throw towards first for out number two. Wiley Jackson, unfortunately, to make the play at first. Aaron McCree is one out away from a completed game. Up next, we have number 13, Austin Hill for the Braves.
Pitcher 13, Austin Hill.
Austin Hills is a junior infielder. Don't know his exact position. First pitch is first strike. Count moves to 0-1. One delivery underway. A little high. Count moves to 1-1.
Flip a coin, man.
The 1-1 delivery from McCree is fouled back. Count moves to 1-2. Aaron McCree is one pitch away complete game. One, two, delivery. Strike three in the completed game comes from Aaron McCree. The Braves struggled throughout the game, trying to get any momentum going, and just the Falcons have given the Braves their first loss of the season. Braves will close out the series tomorrow at noon. Thank you for watching.
Tomorrow at noon.